Hello everybody, it's Jeff with AZ Camera Reviews, and today I'm going to be talking about Guardian Electric Garage Door Operators. Now that is a mouthful. Anyway, how often have you pressed your remote only to hear this sound? Well, if you hear it 12 times, it usually means the master circuit board inside your control head is going bad or is bad. Now, some people are able to fix it by just rapping 3 times on the back of the unit, just under the limit and the down switch, by taking the back of a screwdriver or a hammer and just giving it 3 taps like this. That may restore it short term. That ends up jiggling the circuit board back so the operator will work. But you don't want to get stranded sometime where you have to be somewhere in a hurry and all of a sudden find that this thing doesn't work. So I'm going to show you now how you can fix it. It's a pretty simple fix, and you can order the parts online and do this yourself. Normally, it costs you about $69 to have a guy from the electric garage door opener company just come to your house. He'll end up soaking you on the circuit board, and then he'll probably end up also soaking you on the price of the installation. For those that can't do, it's probably well worth it. But for me, forget it. I'd rather do it myself. So here we go. Remember, before starting the process, remove the power from the outlet above. Now, this outlet is pretty shabby, and this will be a feature of one of my next videos. This is the way that electrical box was when I moved into my home. So the first thing we're going to do is remove both of these light covers. You can remove the light covers real easily. Just press the button on the side like this and pull them down. So that's one, and then we'll remove this. That's two. Now, on the top side of this, there's 2 screws here, there's 2 screws here, there's 2 screws here, and then there's 2 screws on the back. But before you remove those screws, what you want to do is rubber band this together so then that way the whole thing doesn't come apart. Because it's basically like 4 pieces, and if you put the rubber band around it, it won't all separate on you. So we're going to do that next. So I have my 2 bungee cords here. I have 1 thin black one, and then I have 1 red one. And what I'm going to do is take both of these bungee cords, and I'm going to put them together like that. And I'm going to reach around the back side of the unit, and I'm going to hook both of these bungee cords together. So they put pressure on the box and the box won't fall apart. Now, we're gonna remove the 8 screws. So there's 2 screws here, there's 2 screws on the back side, there's 2 screws on this side, and then there's 2 screws all the way on the back. The second thing that's very important is to label these wires here, which are your photo eye and your push button. You're gonna have to remove these wires before you're gonna be able to drop the case. Now that our wires are marked, we're ready to remove them. So now that our wires have been disconnected from here, they've been labeled, and I also have the push button secured here so it doesn't fall back, we're going to remove the cover. So it's a pretty simple task. We're going to unscrew this first screw here, which is screw number 7. We had already removed the 2 screws here, 2 screws there, 2 screws off the back. And now we're going to remove this last screw. Okay, and there we go. And we're going to slide the box forward a little bit, and we're going to let it drop and hang by the light bulb attachments. Now, this right here is the circuit board that you're going to want to swap out. So now we're looking at the back of the board, and you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 connectors. You're going to remove these connectors, and it's basically been idiot-proofed. There's the red goes with the red, the black goes with the black, the white goes with the white, and this is a multi-connector, and this has 3 connections. So let's pull this one out. Okay, let's pull the next one out. Let's pull the red. Let's pull the black. They're a little tough. And last but not least, we'll pull the white. Okay, so now all our connectors are free. We're going to go back over to the other side, and we're going to undo the 2 screws. So this is the other side of the circuit board. The connectors are on this back side over here. And this is the front side. And you've got 2 Phillips-style screws here. So we're going to take our screwdriver, and we're going to unscrew these 2 screws. Okay, here's one. Now we're going to take the second one out. Okay, we remove those. Now we're going to gently, from behind and from the front right here, we're going to push this forward and pull the board off of these 2 locking screws, and we're going to pull the board straight off. So this is how your replacement board comes from North Shore Commercial Door. Hey, that's kind of a neat rhyme. Anyway, when you open the box, you just open the box up, and inside is your new circuit board and the receiving wire. Let's just for giggles compare both boards side by side. They're basically the same in layout. They have the same thing that makes the beep. They've got the resistors basically in the same place. They've changed out these components here with these components right here. They still have 2 transistors. But one thing I want you to take notice of, when I remove this board from the actual control head, I left these black brackets in place. So those 2 silver screws that I had to unscrew beforehand, I'm going to have to remove these brackets and then set this new board on the old brackets that I left in the control head. Putting this back together is basically the same way I took it apart, and we'll be back once I get it back together. Okay, so now we've got the unit totally put back together, but there's a couple of things I want to remind you of before you walk away from the project. Now, number one, remember the wires we had up here? Well, they're color-coded, and what you want to do is you want to make sure the 2 black wires are towards the inside, and that's on the photo eyes. The other thing that's left now is we have to program the limits of the up and down, and I'm going to show you how to do that now. So setting your limits is pretty simple. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to come over here to your limit button, and you're going to click it once. And what's going to happen is the up light is going to come on. You're going to come over here to your up button, and you're going to click it until the garage door is up to where you want the opening stop to be. Then stop, take your finger off the button, and hit the limit switch once. The OK button will light, and now what you want to do is you want to set the down. So you're going to hit your limit switch twice, and the red light will come on, and now you're going to hit your down button. Now you're going to keep the down button pressed until it reaches the total bottom of where you want it to meet the cement. So now you've got that set, so you're going to click that once. Now you'll get OK, and your up and down is set. Now what you're going to do is you're going to adjust your force, and that's going to be done automatically. The door is going to come up, then it's going to come down. Now, after it goes through with that procedure, it's going to beep. That means everything has been set. So there you have it, the easy way to replace the controller board in your Guardian 628. It takes between a half an hour to 45 minutes. Take your time, don't do it fast. You want to do a quality job. Until next time, I'm Jeff with AZ Camera Reviews saying, please watch us, please like us, please share us, and most of all, please subscribe. Until next time, bye-bye.